finally, we are going to test the synthesizability of the project that we did on MolarSim on Intel RTL devices. So we need Quartus II environment to do this. So as usual, we launch Quartus II and then start a new project. 99% chances all projects that you develop in MolarSim will be runnable on Quartus II. So just open the folder where you save your module.v and just copy and paste in a new module in Quartus II. We want only the module Verilog. You can open in any text file first, and then from there you can copy and paste into Quartus II. That is it. Save it and create a project for this Verilog. Let us create a new folder named M123456Q2. Don't forget to open the folder and then we rename the .v so that it is the same as the module name. At this level, let us save only as Cyclone 2 devices. Having the project done, we just compile it. Let us take a look at RTL Viewer. Look pretty much what we expect in our data unit data flow. We have product 1, product 2, the 2 multiplexer, 1 multiplier, 1 divider, and this is the state register for the FSM. If your code generate a clear state machine for your FSM, Quartus II will be able to extract that state machine as a drawing like this. And then you can double click and you can see the actual state machine transition that is performed by your state machine in your control unit. Then the next level of verification is the simulation. We go back to the MolarSim folder, then take the unsigned decimal simulation text. We are going to give these values to our simulation and we expect to get the respective output. So we start the simulation mode in Quartus II by creating the university program waveform file. We put the output at the bottom. We better make the radix of everything as unsigned decimal, except for the 1-bit lines. First, we give x as 668. This is equivalent to some value in decimal that you can refer to in the text bench module. Y is 1357. Z is 358. Then clock is as usual, is a counting of 1 and 0. And start is a signal which trigger the calculation in the RTL system. The start high signal should be long enough so that it contain both rising and falling edge of the clock. So the best duration is 2 clock cycle. Let us not snap to grid in this case because start signal should be free from clock boundary, or in other words, it should be asynchronous or independent of clock because it is actually a totally different input signal that does not depend on clock. Let's say this is one start signal. That's it. So we expect, because in our design, there are 3 states after the start signal going down. So we need at least 3 clock cycles after start signal going down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's say we give another 3 clock cycles so that we are allowing enough time for the system to stabilize and finish everything. But anyway, we can make the second start signal anywhere after that finish. So the purpose of this second start signal is for us to put the second set of input value. So to put the second set of input value, we snap to grid again, go back to the simulation result. Next value of x is 2662. Next value of y is 2995. Next value of z is 77. Remember that all these values are not the actual value, but the value in 16.8 fixed point notation. So, hope this is it. We can save the waveform. If we run the simulation, we need to set the option to run as Quartus 2 simulator. Then, we run the functional simulation first. So, do we get the value of F1429? Yes, we got it. And the next one should be 58622. Yes, we get 58622. In the second set of input value, we get it equally in model sim and Quartus 2. Just one more extra thing to do. Let us run this as timing simulation. We still get the expected result, but you can see here the big line or stripes of black here is the delay due to the mega function of multiplication and division. That's it. You can make all these screenshots of timing simulation, functional simulation, state machine, RTL view, and the report of the compilation to tell how many logic elements that this system is using when it is synthesized on Cyclone 2. So all this you can compose in your report and write something in your report. Other than that, you can look at under Project Navigator, under Files tab, you can see the module file and also the waveform file. Under Hierarchy, you can see in the module that we compile in Quartus 2, it is listed under the name as LPM divide. This is the divider mega function. And the other mega function is LPM mult. So it is obvious here, we are using only one multiplier and one divider. That is it. Good luck, and I hope you get a great result with your assignment.